The history of the ancient Sudan has been unknown to the great public, but also to science since many, many generations. This has changed in the middle of the 19th century when a Prussian expedition headed by a certain Richard Lepsius was sent to an archaeological exploration campaign to the Nile Valley. And Lepsius, this is really extraordinary, had decided from the very beginning of his planning to include the Sudanese Nile Valley in this travel plan. And he was the first to explore carefully all the visible remains of the great ancient history of the Sudan from Aswan up to Khartoum and Sennar on the Blue Nile. The real explosion, I would say, of archaeological work in the Sudan started only in the last decades after the Second World War. And here, Germany has played a considerable role. First, the Humboldt University in Berlin. And then different institutions all over Germany. Right now, we have 10 German expeditions working in the Sudan, and the results of these excavations and the connected studies have brought, I would say, a revolution of our knowledge. Nowadays, we know for sure that the cultural evolution started in the Sudan at least in the 10th millennium BC, and comparable developments in the Egyptian Nile Valley had to wait for 5,000 years. This means the roots of pharaonic civilization and therefore the roots of Greek and Roman and finally European civilization in general lie in the north of the Sudan. When Egypt woke up, so to say, at around 4,500 BC, the Sudan had already a long cultural tradition. I think this is an important message, not only for scholars, not only for science, but this is an important message for the Sudan in general. This could give and should give the country the self-consciousness to be the cradle of human civilization, not only in Northeast Africa, but in the ancient world in general.